One translation of a famous Archimedes quote is, "Give me a place to stand, and with a lever, I will move the whole world." Let's discuss a visual proof of the mean inequalities that Archimedes would appreciate. Start with two positive real numbers, a less than or equal to b. Consider a fulcrum with a platform, and mark distances a on both sides of the fulcrum, and b on both sides. Then place weights of mass a on both sides, and weights of mass b on both sides, but at switch distances. Since the heavier weight is farther on the right side, the system will rotate clockwise if left to move. Now place two weights of mass A at opposite B distances, and two weights of mass B at opposite A distances. Because these weights counteract one another, the net moment of the system is the same and it will rotate clockwise. Finally, construct the midpoint of A and B, A plus B over 2, and move the A plus B weights on the right to this midpoint. The weights are equal and moved equal but opposite distances, so once again the net moment is unchanged. The moment to the left of the fulcrum is 2a times b plus 2b times a. And the moment on the right is 2a plus 2b times a plus b over 2. Because the system rotates clockwise, the left moment is less than or equal to the right moment. And this inequality can be rewritten as 4ab is less than or equal to the quantity a plus b squared, which implies that the square root of a times b is less than or equal to a plus b over 2. This is the arithmetic mean, geometric mean inequality. Let's revisit the same weighing, but this time noting that 1 over b is less than or equal to 1 over a. So on the fulcrum and the platform, we can mark the distances 1 over b and 1 over a, and drop weights of mass 1 over a and 1 over b on both sides at switch distances. The heavier weight is again farther away from the fulcrum on the right, so that the system will rotate clockwise if left to move. We place a 1 over b mass at distance 1 over a on both sides of the fulcrum, and then a 1 over a mass at distance 1 over b at both sides. These don't affect the net moment of the system, so it will again rotate clockwise. Move the right side masses equal and opposite distance to the midpoint 1 half 1 over a plus 1 over b, which still maintains the same net moment. Let's compare the moments again. The left moment is computed by 2 over b times 1 over a plus 2 over a times 1 over b, and the right side moment is 2 over a plus 2 over b times 1 half 1 over a plus 1 over b. Because the system rotates clockwise, we have this inequality. The inequality simplifies to 4 over ab is less than or equal to the quantity 1 over a plus 1 over b squared, which eventually implies that 2 over 1 over a plus 1 over b is less than or equal to the square root of ab. This is the harmonic mean, geometric mean inequality. Let's revisit the original fulcrum and platform with distances A and B on either side. Remember, we have masses A and B on either side as well, but at switched distances. This system, if left to move, will rotate clockwise because the heavier weight is further away on the right. Next, let's drop masses of size A at distance A and masses of size B at distance B. This does not affect the net moment of the system, so again we will still rotate clockwise. Now, move the two left weights of size a plus b equidistant to this midpoint a plus b over 2. Once again, this doesn't change the net moment of the system. Computing the moments on the left and the right reveals the following. The left moment is 2a plus 2b times a plus b over 2, and the right moment is 2a times a plus 2b times b. Because the system rotates clockwise, the left moment is less than or equal to the right moment. This inequality can be rewritten as the quantity a plus b squared is less than or equal to 2 times the quantity a squared plus b squared, which means that eventually a plus b over 2 is less than or equal to the square root of a squared plus b squared over 2, which is the arithmetic mean, quadratic mean inequality. The first system of weights showed us the arithmetic mean, geometric mean inequality. The second system of weights showed us the harmonic mean, geometric mean inequality, and the third system of weights showed us the arithmetic mean, quadratic mean inequality. We can put these three inequalities together to get one long string of inequalities. The string of inequalities says that the harmonic mean is less than or equal to the geometric mean, is less than or equal to the arithmetic mean, which is less than or equal to the quadratic mean. Of course, if we think back to this system, we see that we'll get equality throughout if and only if A equals B, so that the actual system never rotates but is perfectly balanced. Thus, we have a physical proof worthy of Archimedes' approval of the mean inequalities.